I did the film actually to show how the difference between what a responsible, you know, open-minded black man would do in raising his son. And so I could contrast that to the way, you know, his son's two friends would be raised just by their mother.
Mm-hmm.
And what we show in this film, you know, there's a mother in the film who raises her two sons, and one she overly loves, and he becomes irresponsible and a teenage father. And the other one she doesn't love enough, and he becomes a gangster. Mm-hmm.
Back in 2008, 2009, I joined Philadelphia Alumni Kappa League program when I was in high school. I was in the 11th grade of high school, and then I moved on to college. I've joined Philadelphia Alumni Chapter of Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated in 2015 in the fall.
As Linwood Green III, I am currently the Interim Director of Finance for International Headquarters at Kappa Alpha Psi. I'm a part of the Philadelphia Alumni Chapter. I was initiated into the Gamma Omega chapter in spring of 2003, and I'm currently the vice president of the Kappa League and Achievement Academy.
He's Carter. I'm a spring 2013 initiate into the Gamma Sigma chapter of Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated. Currently, I serve as the president of the Achievement Academy board for the Philadelphia Alumni chapter of Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated.
One of the reasons I mentor with the Kappa League program is because it's needed in our community. There's a lack of black male presence in a lot of our African-American communities. And it's a part of our obligation as members of Kappa Alpha Psi. It's one of the things that we become members for, to actually give back. It's a part of our principles, vision, and our five objectives.
I decided to come back and mentor in Kappa Achievement Academy simply because I was mentored in here as well.
I was fortunate to have some really great mentors that happened to be brothers of Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated before I joined this organization. And the one thing that was guaranteed was to pay it forward. And the one way that I see paying it forward, giving back, was to go back and mentor those that were in my shoes that didn't have all the resources.
I'm definitely trying to instill the sense of community and brotherhood in this program. A lot of our young men, our students today, they're a little timid, they're a little shy when they come in. So getting to know them on a personal level really helps us connect with them and really get them to see us on their level.
Just the fact that, you know, there's always people there for you, mm-hmm. you know, people you can always reach out to that have your best interests. And it's something that you don't see a lot of. And, you know, I was glad I was able to see so much of it, you know.
The best things I found from the Kappa League is it's a new family. We learn new lessons on developing ourselves as black men in America. Although you're the new person, you're the underdog here, you can still accomplish many things. It's what you make out of it. I decided that I wasn't going to be quiet no more. I was going to put pressure to my name and have a voice in the Kappa League. And that's what I want other boys and teenagers to come in this program. When you come to this program, don't be shy. Open up to people, make new bonds, make new connections, stand out. That's the best thing you can do in life, in the Kappa League and life, is stand out. Be different from others. Become the leader that you can be.
Community service, got my Kappa Leaguers.
It's gonna be down to the food.
It is. We out.